I think it is very important for all of us to realize that hypertension is an ongoing health crisis issue. It is often known as a silent killer because it is associated long-term with heart disease, stroke, as well as chronic kidney disease and failure. We want to avoid our patients to reach to that level by treating that hypertension early on. As we speak, more than 50 million Americans suffer from hypertension, but only 2/5 of those patients are appropriately treated or have their blood pressure under control. This stems from this fundamental concept that we don't really have that many options other than medications. My name is Dr. Alpesh Shah. I'm an invasive cardiologist at Houston Methodist Hospital. I'm the director of coronary interventions. The introduction of renal denervation therapy is a game changer. It is completely going to revolutionize what we can offer our patients. Houston Methodist recently became the first hospital in Houston to offer this groundbreaking procedure, which is currently the only non-pharmacologic therapy offered to our patients with hypertension. The renal denervation procedure comes from this concept that renal arteries carry efferent nerves, and these efferent nerves are constantly giving signals to our central nervous system, which allows for blood pressure control. So in some of our patients, when those nerves are hyperactive, that leads to hypertension as well as cardiovascular morbidities associated with that. So in doing this procedure, what we are trying to do is ablate these hypersensitive renal efferent nerves with electrical or radio frequency stimulation. This procedure involves accessing the femoral artery through the groin. Once we have advanced our catheters into the bilateral renal arteries, we first perform an angiogram. Angiogram is done to confirm the size of the vessel and also to rule out any additional renal artery stenosis, which is also an exclusion for these patients to get RDN therapy. Once that has been eliminated and we are confident about our anatomy, we will go ahead and advance the Simplicity catheter. This catheter is very unique design. It is helical design and it has four electrodes in a longitudinal manner, 8 millimeters apart. And through that, radio frequency energy is delivered, just like you would see in your patient with atrial fibrillation ablation, not that dissimilar. And that energy allows for denervation of the efferent renal nerves. We are enrolled in a national study called Spiral Affirm Hypertension. This is a single-arm, multi-center prospective trial which will plan to enroll 1,000 patients, and they'll be followed up for 6 months, 12 months, and up to even 5 years. Fortunately, this is a minimally invasive cath lab-based procedure, so the risk to our patients is minimal. All said and done, most of our patients are able to be discharged the same day in the evening, and they continue to do very well in terms of safety. We have data from Europe for almost a decade-long follow-up on those patients, and vast majority of patients have reduced their systolic blood pressure anywhere from 12 to 15 millimeters of mercury. And not only that, this benefit has been sustained not for 6 months, not for 12 months, not for 3 years, but almost up to 10 years in those European data. Our own experience has been very encouraging. All our patients have done phenomenally well. They have already shown signs of improvement in their blood pressure control, but we'll continue to follow those patients under the study protocol and hope for the best results for each and every one of those patients long-term. Initially, when we started doing our clinical trial work, we focused on our resistant hypertension patients, and that was a perfect group, and we felt that there was already a derived benefit from that. But eventually, we started looking at other patients. What about all our 50-year-old patients? And imagine their life. For the next 20, 30, 40 years, they will be stuck on those blood pressure medications. Most of our patients require not just one, but often two or three or even more medications. Not only sometimes they can be expensive, some of the newer medications require approval, but also in spite of medical therapy, in spite of taking several medications, vast majority of our patients are still not reaching our goals. So now with this revolutionary breakthrough approach of a catheter-based minimally invasive therapy, we are really looking forward to helping our patients with hypertension, possibly to reduce their need for blood pressure medication and maybe even eliminate those.